Joey. Have a seat, doll.
Hey, thanks for seeing me, Bobby. Look, I know we blew it by turning down that nurse's thing, but I gotta believe there is something bigger for me right around the corner.
Listen, you are living in a dream world.
Excuse me?
That nurse's show is huge. Everyone involved with it is gonna become insanely rich, and it's gonna haunt you for the rest of your life. But my job is to keep up your morale.
I do feel better.
Look, I'm a straight shooter, but I'll tell you something else about me. I am the best. There is nothing that I wouldn't do for you. I would throw on a meat skirt and wrestle a lion. I would pull off my own ears and eat them.
That's gross.
I am gonna get you through this. I tell you, next year, I am gonna find you a show that'll blow this nurse's thing right out of the... What the hell am I saying? Nothing's gonna top that!
Hold on. Next year? No, no, no. I need to get something now.
Well, I got nothing. Zilch. Zero. Nada.
There's gotta be something.
Well, they do need a host for this new entertainment news show. It's not really acting, but it may work since you have such a tremendous head.
I do?
Oh, come on. We don't have time for this.
Thanks, Bobby. Thank you.
Looks like you got a big barrel on your shoulders. Joey, what are you doing here? Why aren't you out there getting work?
Didn't have any auditions today.
Oh, sure. Put it all on me. What's that?
Oh, it's a portfolio of hairstyles.
What? Oh, who's the model? Oh, but I'd like to keep that little piece of chicken in my pocket and snack on him all day.
That's my nephew.
Well, we can see who has the looks in your family.
Anyway, my sister is a hairdresser, and that's her portfolio. I was hoping maybe you could show it to some of your clients.
Oh, absolutely. Hi, Halle Berry. My client has a sister who's a barber. Could she do your hair for the Oscars?
What'd she say?
Joey, I'm not here to do you personal favors. Let me explain how this agent thing works. First, you become famous, and then I'll kiss your ass. But until then, let's keep it strictly professional.
Okay, sorry. I understand.
Leave the pictures of the boy toy. Oh. Joey, I've got great news.
Oh, did I get that commercial?
No, I bought a horse.
Joey, come on, I gotta get to school.
Oh, hi, I'm Michael.
Have a seat. Joey, I completely forgot. There's a residual check for you in the accounting department. Why don't you go grab it?
All right, okay, I'll be right back.
I'll be right back.
So, Michael, how do you feel about full frontal nudity?
I'm not an actor.
Oh, yes, I know. Joey, thank you for coming in. Listen, the reason that I called...
No, you didn't call me. I called you.
Oh, good. I was just about to make something up.
Okay, look, Bobby, I got a real problem and I need your help. I took an understudy role in this play.
Oh, no, I hate plays.
No, that's not the problem.
Oh, it gets worse?
Well, I signed up to understudy in 3 different plays and they all want me to go on tonight.
What? Oh, why Why can't you just have a coke problem like everyone else?
I'll give that some thought.
All right. You have to do three plays at once. Well, lucky for you, I am the queen of multitasking. Right now, as we are talking, I am doing butt clenches. And I'm learning Spanish in this earpiece. Me llamo Bobby. I'm trying to seduce a Mexican soap star. All right. Let's see if we can juggle these. All three plays are at the same time?
No. One starts a little earlier. Oh, and one, I'm not in until the second act.
Great! So you can do both of those. And for the third, maybe we can get the actor to go on.
Oh, how am I gonna do that?
Well, I'd offer to call and threaten to ruin his career, but it couldn't get much worse. He's doing a play.
Maybe I can just go talk to him.
You do that. You'll think of something to say. You're a big, bright guy.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Really? Enough of that Donde esta la playa crap. How do you say, take off my bra?
Quítame mi brasiel.
Yeah, well, Mother, I don't understand what you're so upset about. So they're gonna remove your uterus. What do you need it for? Look, I gotta go. Yeah, I love you too. Bye.
What did you want to see me about?
Yeah, I wanted to explain to you how the business works. See, you book a job, and I get 10%. Do you know what 10% of zero is?
Six goes into 40.
God! I have never wanted to slap you more. You are screwing up your career. You don't show up for an audition, you scream at a casting director.
Well, the only reason I did that is because he's deaf.
Who told you that?
Oh, this actor. I see him at all my auditions. He gives me pointers.
Oh, wait a second. Is he the reason why you went into an audition, you threw away your script, and you started barking?
Yeah, did I get that part?
Oh, Joey, he's messing with your head.
What?
Yeah, your little friend is shoving crap up your pooper. Joey, you're such a sweet, naive guy. But you can't let people take advantage of you.
I really liked him. I can't believe this.
Yeah, well, I can't believe they take the fat out of my ass and put it in my lips, but they do. Oh, well, he's just walking in right now. I'll tell him. Great news, Joey. I just got you the lead in an industrial safety video.
What? No. I don't want to do any more stuff like that. Look, Bobby, I came to L.A. to take the next step in my career, and I feel like I'm taking a step back. You know, you got me doing these lame auditions, lousy commercials, that mystery theater thing at Ted Danson's house. Well, I need things to change now.
Ooh. There's the fiery Latin heartthrob that I took a chance on.
I'm not Latin, I'm Italian.
Italian? Oh, no. Italians are out this year. Maybe time for you to call in your boy band connections.
I wasn't in a boy band.
I can't catch a break.
Look, Bobby, you gotta do whatever it takes to get me something, and something good. Otherwise, I'm gonna go out and find someone else who will.
Okay, look, just give me one more chance. I will find you something. There's gonna be no more celebrity parties, okay? No more cheesy commercials. Oh, and when you get home, just delete the message about emceeing the dog show.
All right, okay, that's more like it. Now, is there anything I can do on my end?
Yeah, it'd be great if you had some connections. Who have you met in this business who's powerful? I mean, someone who loves you, someone you trust.
Just you, I guess.
Oh, you sweet thing, come here. Oh, God, I could slap a diaper on you and nurse you right now.
Hello?
Joey, I did it. I got you a huge audition for tomorrow.
That was fast. What happened?
Well, apparently your friend from Northwestern called the producer. And then the producer called me and offered you the audition. And I said, okay.
That's great. Okay, well, what's it for?
Well, it's a sexy new nighttime drama set in a mountain resort. It's called Deep Powder. It's Baywatch on skis. And it's the dumbest script I ever read. It's gonna be huge.
All right.
Yeah, I'm gonna have my assistant fax you the audition scene as soon as I get off the phone.
Great.
There he is, the star of the new show, Deep Powder.
Bobby, hi. Come on in.
Wow. What are you doing here?
How would you like to go to Las Vegas and be a celebrity judge? It would be great publicity for your new show.
Bobby, I told you, I don't want to do stuff like that anymore.
It's a beauty pageant.
Anything for the show.
It's Miss Southwestern USA, but they need you to leave for Las Vegas tonight.
Tonight?
Well, you weren't their first choice.
Okay, all right, fine. What's involved in judging?
You have to look at beautiful women and rate them on a scale of 1 to 10. Can you do that, Joey?
I'll give it a try. Okay, this is great. But why did you come by to ask me? You could have just called.
Well, I like to give my clients the personal attention. Michael! You are here.
Oh, gosh.
Well, you're filling out nicely. Couple more months and you'll be ready.
I'm okay. You know what? Thanks for stopping by, Bobby. Here you go.
All right. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wait, I know someone who can help us.
Hello.
Hey, Bobby, it's Joey. Listen, I got myself into a situation. It's bad.
Okay, here's the game plan. Flush the drugs, throw the gun in the river. We'll tell everyone it was exhaustion.
No. I need you to come down to the set. I've been seeing my daughter on the show, and she locked herself in her dressing room, and now we can't do the scene with the bear.
Every time I'm about to give up on this business, something wonderful like this happens. I'll be right there.
Okay.
Where are they? Oh.
Bobby, thank God.
Sorry it took me so long. They've been reluctant to let me on the lot since I punched David Caruso.
Hello, Bobby. For a second there, I thought the bear had gotten loose.
And I thought I dropped one of my earrings.
Do you two have some kind of history?
We dated the same guy.
That dude does not have a clear type.
So what's the problem?
Katie still won't come out of her dressing room.
Well, don't you worry. I know how to deal with crazy actors. You just smile and tell them what they want to hear.
Okay, you think you can help me?
Absolutely. Katie, it's Bobbie Morganstern.
The agent?
The super agent. Entertainment Weekly's 12th most powerful woman in Hollywood.
67.
Now, Katie, I know you don't want to talk to Joey, but if you could just give me a minute, maybe I can help you out here. Oh, she's tiny too. Maybe I could pick you both up and have you talk to each other.
So, 67, huh?
No small talk.
Yeah.
Great news.
She's coming out?
No, I signed her as a client.
You did what?
That's right. My client, Katie, demands that you fire Joey. But if you fire my client, Joey, I'll destroy you.
Isn't this a conflict of interest?
Oh, no. They'll send me to agent jail. Michael. Oh, I thought that was you. Oh, aren't you a sexy little fancy man?
Well, Joey didn't tell me you'd be here.
Oh, he didn't tell me that you'd be here. I mean, if he had, I wouldn't have brought Data.
Look, Bobby, come on. You're my agent. You know I don't like that. I was just telling him I don't want to talk about Data.
You listen to me, Mr. Roboto. Michael is a fan. And if he wants you to be Data, then you be Data. He wants you to be R2-D2, then I want to hear blippity-blop squawk. Now, I'm gonna give you boys a chance to talk. One day, you'll return the favor. Hard.
Bobby, hey, thanks so much for coming.
I got an advance copy of the show. You were fabulous.
Really?
Yeah, I laughed my ass off.
It's a drama.
Oh, no, I don't think so. Oh, God.
Hey, could you keep it down?
Well, I am not going to keep it down. That's my client. It's the funniest thing in there. Oh, well, look who's here, an hour and a half late.
I'm so sorry, Bobby.
What's gotten into you? You're late all the time. Last night, you missed the benefit with the lingerie models.
Well, did they raise a lot of money? Will those girls get the help they need?
You are very erratic lately. Are you doing some new designer drug that you might have on your person?
No, it's just I've been working so much that I'm having a hard time keeping track of things.
Well, you need to find a personal assistant.
You think that'd help?
Oh, sure. They'll run errands for you. They organize your personal life. Plus, they do tricks. Watch this. Jason, could you be a doll and come in here with a cup balanced on your head? Jason, say hi to Joey Tribbiani.
Hello. I have a master's degree.
Thanks, dear. That's all for now. Back in the box.
All right. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna get an assistant. Any advice?
Well, you need to find someone who's a good fit for you. And personally, I'm always pro-gay. They smell good, and they got those quick little fingers.
Bobby, I want to remind you, we have a 4 o'clock departmental meeting.
Thank you, Jason. Now do the robot for Joey. Make yours do it.
Bobby, first of all, his name is Glenn. Second, I don't make my assistant do tricks. It's not the kind of boss I am. I don't just think of him as an employee, I think of him as a friend.
Thanks, Joey.
Even though the robot is a fun dance and I do enjoy watching it, especially when done skillfully.
Jason, get in there. Now fight! Hey, Joey.
Bobby. Hey, everyone. This is my agent, Bobby.
Hello, everyone. I just watched your last scene. Wow, you're all so lucky to have work. What do you think? You excited to do it?
What are you talking about?
Did I not tell you? I'm a little off. I was at the gate looking through my purse for my wallet, and I accidentally tasered myself.
So what's the news?
Well, the Tonight Show had a cancellation for tomorrow, and they called to ask me if I had anyone who could fill in. I suggested you, and they said yes.
You're kidding.
I'm as stunned as you are.
I'm gonna be on the Tonight Show? Oh my God! This is unbelievable. This is like one of those moments I've dreamed of my whole life. The only thing bigger than this would be, I don't know, like making my Oscar speech.
Oscar? Did you get tasered too?
Never gonna make it there on foot. Oh, I'm gonna call Bobby and see what my options are.
Oh. Hello?
Bobby? Is that you?
I just tasered myself again. I think on some level, I may be doing it on purpose.
Look, I need you to find out what the Tonight Show does if someone's late.
Oh, I am so on it.
Hold on.
Joey.
Yeah?
I talked to the producers, and it turns out if you're late, they give away your spot and you're banned from the show for life.
That's terrible. Isn't there anything else you can do?
Do you have any idea how hard it was for me to crawl there?
Hello?
Joey, it's 10 minutes before you're supposed to go on. Can you get here?
I'm trying.
I need to know now. Because if you can't make it, they're gonna send out the guy from the zoo with his snake.
Oh, man. I'm not gonna be on the show, and I'm missing the snake.
Look, I'm gonna have to tell him you can't make it.
I'm sorry, honey.
Yeah, all right, I guess you should.